Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back. Hope you had a good day in the markets. Wednesday, March 8th. We're going to look at a little technical analysis. Jay Powell talked today. Look at SPY. GME Tops was on a runner today. And Kala, Helbiz. We trade some futures. Natural gas, we're going to look at those. BBY, of course. Hit the multi-decade low. We'll check out some day on that as well. Sub up, like up, comment down. Happy Money sticks around. Follow us on Twitter at HappyMoneyYT. Follows our Discord server, link for those are in the description. We've got a tweet from Ryan Cohen in Chinese saying hello, and that's it. So SPY was pretty mellow today. The statements from yesterday are basically the same for today, so wasn't a whole lot of surprise. Market was pretty flat. Did have Jolt's job data, which was hot still, so that's bearish, but didn't affect the market too much. This red candle was when he basically started to just big sell off, but then it mellowed out. And I traded futures on it. I figured once, unless if there was a crazy question that really pushed the market, it seemed like it was just going to trade some kind of sideways. And then I thought once it was over, it'd probably sell off. And like clockwork, like literally right when it was over, you got this candle. So I went short here. Well, actually, I went short. I caught this move down. Yeah, I caught this move down. And then I actually got greedy and went for a long here, which wasn't too bad. I didn't know when the meeting was ending, so took a small loss, closed it out here and went short, and then closed that out here. So a little bit of futures, and then opened up a short here, one, and then scaled in like three or four more micro ES shorts up here. So I have those for now. Might hold them till tomorrow. The stop loss, we'll see. But yeah, the trend still looks down, and from Jay Powell's statements yesterday, it's pretty bearish. Still some more data this week that could move stuff around, but we've got red under the 9 moving average, or bearish MACD, which we never got rid of even with this crazy rocket pattern formation. This inverted hammer up here is bearish, of course, big sell-off yesterday. And so, yeah, I'm not seeing a support or bounce yet at this point. Then it will be a red candle under the 9 moving average, so probably some more downs. I thought today's velocity would have been a little bit greater. We got 40 minutes to go, so I suppose we could get a sell-off in today. But nothing too crazy yet. Tops, let's look at GME. Had an interesting bounce today, so we kind of double bottomed on the short term. It's like 1750 area, and then kind of bounced out of there. But the way it rejected 1940, which is a pretty historical support from back here, I'm still bearish on it. I still have the red under the 9. Bearish MACD, but we do kind of see that little double bottom on here, so we'll see if we get price action continuing up. We'll just look for a break of that 1940 for more upside, but so far it's looking like it's probably going to still come back down here to the 16 or so range. And IV still super low, still haven't heard from earnings when that's going to be. AMC has, I guess, their vote coming up. That'll probably add some volatility one way or the other. It does have this head and shoulders here, pretty prominent head and shoulders, head, shoulder, shoulder. But it did help have another one before that it broke out of, so here, and then boom. But yeah, I made another one, so probably gap fill down there at least on AMC. Tops had a move today. We bought in Tops, we were talking about it this week. I bought in back here after this bull flag, like right somewhere around here. Sold off, and then once it broke on the low of that bull flag, I closed it out for a small loss, and then yep, just a little more patience, like two more days, and here we are back up here. So I'm not sure what move is left on this thing this week. Maybe not till next week, just see kind of how it holds up. I have good volume here though today. Green over the 9, bull flagged here. See if we're setting up another one. I'm not sure. This is a pretty big wick now. Build in some of that gap. There's a resistance up there at 129. Didn't quite make it to it, but not sure if it will. This is Kala. This is another one we were in. It's looking good again today. Or I haven't been in this one recently. But yeah, this one actually looks really nice. You have this kind of bull flag, and now it's set up this little cup and handle. And then even right here on the hourly, you have another bull flag. So could be a double topping here, but in the longer time frame, it looks more bullish. So I'm going to say this thing has more upside. We've got our MACD flip bullish. We've got green over the 9. Good volume here on the green days. Today's green candle is engulfing of the red candle. So I like the upside potential right now on Kala. Not sure if it'll happen tomorrow or this week, but it's looking nice. Helbiz had good news. They, I guess, regained compliance, or one of the parameters for compliance on the NASDAQ. So it kind of popped up. TA's not very good looking on it yet, but it's susceptible to volatility. HKD had a rally up. Not sure why, but on the hourly here, we do have an inverted head and shoulders, which is kind of the first time ever on HKD. It looks like it might be hitting a bottom. So that's kind of interesting. Maybe that'll go crazy. And BBBY, last but not least. It hit our low, hit our multi-decade low that was set just back here in January, which was $1.27. Haven't seen that since the 90s. And now we are seeing if we're going to be double bottoming at this level, making RSI divergence or what. I could see it dipping below there, maybe intraday at the very least. And if it does hit a level, I think this 116 would be next. That's the IPO, the high of the IPO in like 1993. So we'll see. Maybe it'll just bounce from here, or maybe we'll get another low. And with that other low, if we have kind of a green day after that new low from here, then that will be setting up an RSI divergence, which is what we're looking for. So I don't see it. I don't see a bottom yet on it. Still kind of bear flag again, though. So I do think we're going to break that 127 still. And yeah, we'll see where support basically comes in, where that buying pressure comes in. They did raise another like $150 million today or something. How much was it? From preferred shares, so not causing any dilution, but raising more capital. I think it was $150 million. Maybe it was more, maybe it was $200 million. Yeah, raised additional proceeds from previously announced public equity offering. So that's bullish. Seems like they're, you know, making moves to pay off debt and lower interest rates or payments. Pay interest and lower the rates. They also, I mean, on their 8K, they also said they renegotiated their loans, and it's like a 200 something page thing. So they did a lot on there. That the highlights I saw looks pretty good at least. I closed out of my 1.5 cash secured puts on it on my trading account here. Took a small loss on it. I'm just thinking it's probably not going to be above 1.5 by Friday, so just wait on that. And then I did do some cover calls in it today. Let's see, did I enter more? I can't remember if I entered more or not. I entered some yesterday. I still have those, so yeah. And then cash secured puts, cover calls, gonna keep farming that theta while it's so high. Yeah, it's just crazy it stayed high so long. So yeah, this week might be the low on it. Very well could be this is the week. And then yeah, GME looks like it does. About to cover. So yeah, there's a cash secured puts that I bought to cover. This was tying up a lot of capital too, so I couldn't even trade hardly any futures. So I had 50 of my close those. I think it was $100 loss on it, so nothing too crazy. And then on... Okay, so I got Cosm shares yesterday. I got GNS shares yesterday. Those are both looking fine. Those actually still look nice. Still both in kind of bull flags. Rubin puts yesterday, these were up like 40%, but Rubin had a bit of a bounce, so now they're actually down 1%. Kind of interesting. Tesla came down quite a bit today, so those, my puts on that. But debit spread came up finally. I've been waiting since, in weeks I've had this play. But yeah, now it's finally broken that kind of support level, so it looks like it probably has a, probably has finally started a downtrend. It might get pretty aggressive the next few days and might be pulling the market even also. So I need a gap fill here in the next couple weeks. Not even. I've got 9 days to get max profit. I need it down here, but I think I'm break even, like 170 something. And then Rivian had a bit of a bounce today, but it just broke all-time lows on news of an offering, so not very bullish on this. I'm gonna hold on to my Rivian. Put debit spread. Not a whole lot of time on it though. That's another just March OPEX expiration. 13, 15 and a half, but debit spread. And let's see, yeah. And then the futures. So nat gas actually did end up going long today. Did a couple dip buys and actually just sold here. I'd like to hold it, but I think this thing might have some more consolidation, maybe some more dips before it really starts to rally. So I'll just kind of keep intraday trading it for now. And yeah, so MES shorts, nat gas, MES, nat gas. So I'm left with 4 short MESs on here, and we'll see if I hold that or not. Not too certain at this point, but that's all I got, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on Discord. Peace out.